Right, one more time. All I have to do is figure out exactly what the perfect formula should be, and then it'll be taken care of for the rest of time, and then I can relax. Just one more step. All I have to do is do it exactly correct, and then everything will be perfect. Right?
OG, OCD, got my mind spinning like an O.C.D. O.C. me, I'm the guy in the back with his thoughts on a roll like an O.A. track. It's a fact that I did it, but the O.C.D.'s like, yeah, what if you didn't? Better check one or three more times. Better yet, better check it like 500. Better check your whole life. When people throw the word around like I'm so O.C.D., I'm like, yo, you may not know what you're professing openly. Though you be so meticulous, it's ridiculous. This isn't what I mean. I mean an incompleteness in the center of my being. As a matter of fact, there's several types, but don't obsess with how they're categorized. There's checking things like locks or lights, or checking if you're sick when you're quite alright. There's the symmetry type with objects. This needs to be where it's not yet, and where it should be is so obvious. It's not a big deal, but your thoughts obsess. Some are non-compulsive. There's no C, there's just pure O. A seed of thought that grows and grows and never stops its surge and growth till you're engrossed. It's all you can know until you fall asleep, and after, even though rationally you can patently see that the thing doesn't actually matter. See, decisions get made up in the prefrontal lobe. Like, hey, my brain, did we make the surface clean, or where's this thing go? And then down below in the limbic system, this can get reinforced, for it's the site of our emotions with their risks and rewards. But when they go rogue, is it known to happen? Then the ventral striatum can snap its cords and zap the cortex into random reactions. And that's when facts and rationality can really subside, and then obsessive thoughts repeatedly lay siege to your mind. I was in my early 20s. I was doing push-ups, deciding how many I should do. 22, that's my age, that's plenty. So then it settled, I'll do 22 for every single day until I'm 23 and so on till I'm dead. But then a little thought made its way into my head. How you gonna do the 90 push-ups when you're 90? 100 when 100? That doesn't seem likely. This little impasse became an obsession I couldn't get past. It lost all connection to getting in shape and became a thought maze that I couldn't escape as I sought the solution to exit the game. A game whose rules were constantly changed by the chemical movements that brewed in my brain. I was doing my push-ups and pushing insane. It's hard to explain. But in a way, I did get over it. It's taken other forms since, but I've gained some control of it. I don't always tell the story, not that those I tell don't care, but its solipsistic nature make it a pain that's hard to share. There are some who've had it harder, some have altered it with pills, some have trusted in the guardianship of therapeutic skill. All who do survive it master their own mind by active will. So whatever be your method, may your mantra keep it still. For the soundless voice of God, or whatever you call God instead, is louder than the voices that resound inside of your head. And whatever blind perfection obsession calls you to pursue will be shattered by the incompleteness that constitutes the truth. There's no such thing as perfect quantities of exercise, no enterprise that lets you hit perfection, for the perfect essence never finds expression in the endless vines of self that twine your being. Open creativity defying OCD.